Hi everyone, hope you're doing well from wherever you're watching this channel, depending on your time zone. Now, there is one song that is trending in Kenya, but it was composed by a Tanzanian musician in Tanzania. In that song, the musician literally looked at all the disadvantages that we are going through here in Kenya, and he focused on that. Definitely, he is mocking William Ruto as the president and to some extent mocking Kenyans, maybe because we have people who also voted for Ruto. So in that way, he's still right. Kuna wale walipigia Ruto kura, na kuna wa Kenya ambao pia sote tunaongozwa na William Samoei Ruto. So Ruto has been mocked, Kenyans have been mocked. And I'm going to put a link to that video so that you can listen to the entire message in the music, because you know music or songs have been used to send a strong message. Sometimes you can communicate using music, and the music has been used as a tool to pass the message. Because of copyright issues, I will just share the link so that you can get to the music. But we are here just to analyze the message in that music. Now, if you listen to the relic, you know, yani Zakayo is the worst thing that ever happened to Kenyans, to Kenya. A disgrace to humanity and the Kenyans at large. That's the truth. Whereby it's very clear that yani president analia, wananchi wanalia, lakini wanajua mwizi, but no one is ready to arrest the thief. Mwizi ni nani? Mwizi ni nani? You know, if you listen to the music, to the song, he's clear about our problem here. Masaa ya kazi, hakuna umeme. We don't have stable power supply in this country. Above all, the power tariffs are not favoring anyone to do business in this country. You heard about JKIA? People are coming in, there is no power. Power blackout in Jomo Kenyatta International Airport. The main gate for this country. Whereby when people land in this country, that's the first face they see. Power blackout. Masaya kazi. So, if that is JKIA, what about huku chini, usisi watu wa village? Maybe you are running, you have a hatchery, umeeka mayai, alafu stima inapotea siku mbili tatu. If you don't have other option, you count losses. Sick people in the hospital, those who are on an ICU, those who are on machine. What happened? It's a disaster. So because of lacking stable power supply, running business becomes a problem. Manufacturing becomes a problem in this country. Then you talk about chakula bei ya juu. That's true. You check on Tanzania, Uganda, Kenya. We have problem here. All basic commodities, zile natumia matumizi ya kila siku. Nyanya, kitunguo, mafuta ya kupika, sabuni, mahindi, unga. Umepanda bei. It's not the same price as other countries. That's why at one point I heard Mzee Museveni, the Uganda president, saying that in Uganda, even a fool can survive because everything is affordable. But if you take some of those people to Kenya or elsewhere, they will die within a day. I think Museveni, in his view, was right. So he even goes further to praise indirectly their president Mama Samia Suluhu, because he's saying that bora sisi tuko afadhali kuliko wao. That in Tanzania, they are fair off compared to us. That kule Kenya, hawasikizwi. Ni nani huyu mwenye nafaa tusikize na hatusiki? The man in the state house, William Samoei Ruto. So that means in Tanzania, there is someone listening to them and answering to their request or demand. Here in Kenya, anytime you come out to speak, you are being branded as Azimio or opposition. So they will not look into the problem you are trying to raise and sort out by providing a solution. Instead, they brand you Azimio. So it's all about politics. Even on serious matters, they would want to play politics. So, ile kazi ambayo imebaki Kenya, kulingana na yule msanii ambayo ameimba wimbo, ni kazi ya kubet. So look at that. Instead of young men being busy in manufacturing industry, earning a living, doing their own business, hata kama ni hawking ni sawa, but now we have been reduced to betting. Tell me, any company that starts a business with an aim of making losses, it never happened that way. You cannot start business to make losses. So betting companies are here. They are not here to make losses. They are here to make profit. So even if betting is happening, no day they will make losses. And our youth, the only thing they can resort to is betting. Pata potea, mchezo wa pata potea. So when you reduce a nation with well-educated young generation to betting, tell me, in 10 years time, tutakuwa wapi kama inchi? We will be in a total mess. Elimu yao utata. CBC is here with us. Hata wale walimu ambao wanafunza CBC, you talk to them, wanakuambia mara nyingi hawajui kile hata wanafunza. Wakienda zile training, hata wale wana train hao walimu, they tell them, hata sisi, tuko on pilot, zani wanajifunza. So no one knows all about CBC. Funding CBC is also a problem. It is being underfunded. So the quality of that education, you give it 5 years or 10 years from now, utapata kuna shida nyingi tu, because someone is underfunding the program. Therefore, even training process, you cannot meet the requirement. So, he goes further to even mention about the dollar. You know, the Kenyan shilling is struggling too with the dollar. Ruto told us that in a couple of months, the dollar, the Kenyan shilling is going to gain value against the dollar. And he even gave us figures. But what happened? The dollar, the shilling is losing value. It is depreciating on daily. Every day you wake up, the shilling is depreciating and the dollar is gaining value. Sasa wanasema kupata dollar hapa Kenya ni shida. It's not easy. I heard even some landlord are asking tenants in Nairobi to pay their rent in dollars. Mambo ya shilingi kando, ushuru sasa tuanze kulipa in dollars. Why? Dollar is becoming expensive. Someone is sleeping on job. All is happening under the leadership of William Samoei Ruto. So wanasema wananchi hapa kupata chakula ni shida. Even getting one meal, it's a struggle to get one meal on a day. So that's the situation in this country. So generally, in as much Kenyans feel they have been mocked in one way or another, kuna mengine I will not mention here. because I don't see sense in that. The fact remains that there is truth in that music, in that song. The person who composed the music had a true message on what Kenyans are going through. Imagine many people educated, good knowledge, but they don't have a job. Hawana kazi. So, huku mbele watu wataanza kujiuliza, what is the value of education if we cannot secure a job? Or if the government cannot provide an enabling environment for business to thrive so that even we can start and run our own business successfully. Itakuwa ni maana gani ya elimu? So in all this, there is a strong message to William Ruto. Tanzania is telling Ruto that you have failed a country and that's why everyone is suffering. So you don't want to be a president. You are not a president. You are a failed president. That's why there is a lot of anger, crying, and the problems in Kenya. I don't know your views, but in the description box, there is a link to the video. And again, in this video, I put a link. You can go and watch. Above all, in the comment section, I'm also going to put the link so that you can go and listen to the message in that music as you enjoy. Thank you so much for listening after this far. And see you in our next video. But let us meet in the comment section to continue with this discussion.